Hello, good evening. Welcome back to our channel. This is the Ubunaya Abo Case, and this is Saturday, 10 p.m. And we are here for our prayer. We pray every Saturday by 10 p.m. GMT plus one. You are welcome, and we'll go right up or straight up into the prayer. Today we'll be considering the story of Mephibosheth, and we'll pray from that story from the book of 2 Samuel chapter 9. It's a story of how God can pick a man. How, you know, beyond your level, God can show you favor. God can show you his kindness. God can just pick you up when you have, it was not, you know, beyond the principles, beyond the hard work, beyond the labor, God can pick you up and, you know, bless you exceedingly. So we'll be praying from that scripture, but first of all, we'll start from Isaiah chapter 6. We'll start by worshiping God. You know, I can never get tired of worshiping God. I don't know about you. So we are going to spend some time in worship. And, you know, worship has a way of granting you confidence, of, you know, stirring up your confidence in God, of stirring up your trust in God. So the book of Isaiah chapter 6, from verse 1, it says, in the year that King Uzziah died. So we note that King Uzziah had died. Isaiah said, in the year that King Uzziah died. That means that in the nation of Israel, probably was a trying time for the nation. Probably, you know, on earth they were wondering, who will be the next king? How will we move forward from here? So the Bible says that in the year that King Uzziah died, he says, I saw the Lord. And Isaiah began to describe how he saw the Lord. And I thought, you know, probably the Lord should be pacing up and down. He should not be sitting on his throne. He should be walking up and down, you know, trying to, you know, say, what do we do now? King Uzziah is dead. Who will be the next king? How do we make my will to happen on earth? But Isaiah says, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting upon the throne. I saw the Lord sitting upon the throne. He says, high and lifted up. Allah comes eternia, and the train of his robe filled the temple. So we see God, and the picture we see is a God that is not pacing up and down, that is not confused about the happenings on the earth. So it means that regardless of what is going on earth, regardless of what is going on in your life, God is on the throne and he's not confused. He's not confused. He says, above it stood the seraphim. Each one has 6 wings. With 2 he covered his face, with 2 he covered his feet, and with 2 he flew. And one cried to another and said, holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. And the posts of the doors were shaken by the voice of him who cried out, and the house was filled with smoke. And when you read the book of Revelations, you understand that that smoke is the smoke of the glory of God. Oh, we see God seated upon the throne. So regardless of the things going on in your life, regardless of the things happening on earth, God is not confused. He's not pacing up and down in the throne room. No, he is seated confidently. He said that he that sits upon the throne shall laugh. You know, he looks at the plans of kings of the earth, of the princes, how they want to, you know, cast off their bonds, and then he sits comfortably and confidently and is laughing at them. So with that understanding, I want you to open up your mouth. And and begin to worship the Lord tonight and begin to give him the praise. Regardless of your circumstance, you know, when you look at those situations and you understand that God is still sitting comfortably on the throne, you will know that that situation is not enough to take away your praise. That situation is not enough to take away your worship. That situation is not enough. It is not enough. It is not enough. Shana makwanze, resuna manakwande. Begin to call God those names that he has revealed himself to you. For our God is a consuming fire. Our God is the Prince of Peace. You are the Lord of Lords. You are the El Gibor. Jesus, we worship you.
Jesus, we give you all the praise. In Sonomoto Berikatosia, go ahead, lift up your voice and worship God tonight. Resani Malakadesia, in Senemalaka Palatia Kapalatania, the one that saved you from the circumstances that you find yourself in, like 2 weeks ago, 1 week ago, 1 month ago, 1 year ago. We are casting our hearts back, we are casting our minds back, and we are thanking the Lord for the victory of the yesteryears. Lord, we give you the praise. Lord, we give you the glory. Je kwanze te bruze bronze parata resuto topal ingrisono monoto resono monoto paru seteniata reprenon palatosia. For praise is comely unto the Lord, praise is beautiful unto Jehovah, praise is comely unto him. Hikasuna kwande resuno monoto poros isa. He is the King of all kings. He is the Lord of all lords. He is the one that neither sleeps nor slumbers. He does not sleep on us. He does not slumber over us. He is continually awake and he is watching. His eyes are continually over us, his children. If it has not been the Lord, we would not have been here. But the mercies of the Lord found us. His grace kept us. Lord, we worship you. Manske dombris afaria taka mingristo baratana. Rescopera divala taka baranda rabalatana. Rapapapapalakiatana namaha. Rapapapalakiatana namanabadaha. Rapapapalatiala namashiminika palada. Eretenene balata. In sonomanuaka prenere pranamaha. Go ahead. Let your worship rise unto the Lord. Let your incense rise. Let your worship. Let your worship rise. Aseto propretia soroba. Repretsumbro franaparata. Resonomolota. In capalatons and ecopreneru asabalata. Ropelofris on somenoa. Eshakadam de rus epenoa. Lentenian. Otenorombre norafalataya. Oh, Jesus. You are the living God. You are the living God. You are the living God. Amasos emparatone rigotomoram derigadala donde renderagata. Repele denemene kapalatananaka. Repere handosana malaka. Repere namaladananana. Ele denenemele tegegenenema shinginiata. Ropopalika malata. Ah, zenendeus everuas empalanosa. Retenemasha. Retenemananas kamalatane. Eretalia, you are the faithful God. You are the promise keeper. You are the covenant keeper. You are the way maker. Lord, you lead us in the path of righteousness. You lead us in the path of righteousness. Yea, though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, Lord, we have not been destroyed, for you are with us. You have been with us. Your rod and your staff have been our protection, our guide. You've been directing our feet. You've not brought us into the way of death, but you kept us in the way of life. Lord, we worship you. Asunaya tonomonoboros intamanada rakwaterus eprodobalata anatos anata lesunayatana. Our hands are lifted up, Lord, to insequanana, to show how our hearts are yielded and lifted unto you. Our hearts are lifted. My heart is lifted in the name of Jesus. Incorpora sinemenoa ratatakwa. There were things that seemed as though they were insurmountable, but God gave you the strength and you went over those things. There were situations that seemed as though you were stuck in them, but the Lord delivered you. Oh Jesus, for the deliverance we worship, for the victories we give you the praise, for the conquest, we give you the glory. Represula vraski manaha astenuad you kwanderus efalatombru fratia kobalata. Yelenos kiton derrika baranos ebenerendo robalata nagada. Rapapapapalato rek kopaliandos English sonomorum deriana tananamakuati rakate sananamalia rusebere derebele kabalanabaha inananana mamalati enerendorabalata inamo shabalata. We worship you, God. We worship you, God. We worship you, God. You have lit a countenance on a son and a cabaron deriatananabalatada inamananamashinganananamaladam. Your love is overwhelming. Your love is overwhelming. Your grace reaches far to us. Rinosa baratayna kuanayeshkinoram derabalatiana. Your mercy reaches us. Inanoshabalanadia. We worship you, God Most High. We worship you, God Most High. We worship you, God Most High. Ayala kadamalataya dadada. Lord, we worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we have worshiped. Amen. Glory to the Father. 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 Lord, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. In the name of Jesus, we have worshiped. Amen. Quickly, we go right into 2 Samuel chapter 9. That is our scripture for prayer today. 2 Samuel chapter 9 from verse 1. He said, now David said, is there still anyone who is left of the house of Saul that I may show him kindness for Jonathan's sake? We'll start the prayer from there. This was David remembering his covenant to Jonathan. And he says, is there still anyone who is left of the house of Saul? David could have forgotten. David could have forgotten, but the Lord made him to remember, and then he was looking for someone in the house of Jonathan. So our first prayer would be that the Lord will cause our helpers to remember us. Every person that the Lord has set as your helper, can you say, Lord, stay, put my picture in the heart of my helper. That man you have destined to help me, is it in my workplace, is it in your workplace, is it in your business, any person, anywhere, there are people, there are men that God sends to you to help you. Sometimes they forget, you know, Joseph, you know, interpreted the dream for his fellow prisoner, and he told him, when you go out, when the Lord restores you, remember me. The man went out and forgot Joseph for a number of years before, you know, God made him to remember at the appointed time. So we are going to be praying and saying, Lord, cause every man that you have destined to be my help to remember me. Go ahead and make that prayer. Jeka Tenerus Ivanatos, that you will not be forgotten. No, you will not be forgotten. Your helper will not forget you in the name of Jesus. Le Rosia Tomonocoperia Subalata, Mekaiton Zenekai Compressova Rahatiada, Lenonzi Gabaram de Ruas Ifenoa. It was so easy for King David to forget about the covenant. It was so easy for him to just be, you know, be consumed by the. The leadership he was in. He was taking his time, but he still remembered. God made him to remember for Mephibosheth's sake. Can you say, Lord, I am not forgotten. In the name of Jesus, my image appears in the hearts of my helpers. In the name of Jesus, anyone that is destined to help me, in the name of Jesus, will help me. In the name of Jesus, and Shakabalo. I am not forgotten in the name of Jesus. I will not be forgotten by my helpers. In the name of Jesus, they remember me right now. You are commanding your image, your picture to appear in the hearts of this man. In the hearts of this man. In the name of Jesus, a son of man, in a supernatural way, reperus epanuati guatanaha. You know, there was another, there's a similar story the Mordecai, he had a similar story. You know, the king, I think he was just restless. And then he says, bring the book of remembrance to me. And then he began to open those that have helped the king. And he reached a man, Mordecai, and he read. He was reading other stories and passing till he got to Mordecai's case, how he helped the king. And he said, has anything been done for this man? Has anything been done? Oh, ayakana manakwa terus efen watana kuatana. Tedekos and Zikoperos and Fanakwa, that could only have been divine. It could only have been divine. It could only have been divine. It could only have been divine. Can you pray and say, let me be remembered in a divine way? In the name of Jesus, I dispense angels. I send angels. In the name of Jesus, these are angels that will bring to remembrance to my face in the heart of every helper that God has sent to me. In the name of Jesus, le rosana makus esanoa reperus ivanoa kapalata elekus ensonobolaka in shanana. I am not forgotten. You declare it yourself. I am not forgotten. You declare to the elements of the air. I am not forgotten. To the sun, to the moon, I am not forgotten. In the name of Jesus, wherever the sun shines, wherever the moon shines, you will bring my remembrance in the name of Jesus. As long as the sun shines, as long as the sun shines, I will be remembered. Lerus apalus equata, reperus embalato, and shananana bababa, reperus and sonobaloga, reperuas unwaka brodora palatosia, and sonamama quatesh and tanaha. Oh, in the name of Jesus, we have prayed that we continue. Verse 2 says, and there was a servant of the house of Saul whose name was Ziba. So when they had called him to David, the king said to him, are you Ziba? He said, at your service. Verse 3, then the king said, is there not still someone of the house of Saul to whom I may show the kindness of God? So we see King David going out of his way. He did not only think about helping a person from the house of Saul. He went out of his way, looked for somebody that could give him the necessary information. That is when God brings your matter into the heart of your helper. The man will not rest. The woman will not rest. And I declare in the name of Jesus, your helper will not rest. That which God wants him or her to do for you is done. In the name of Jesus. Amen. So he says in verse 4. Okay, see verse 3. And Ziba said to the king, there is still a son of Jonathan who is lame in his feet. Was that the question? So we see the king asking Ziba, is there someone? And Ziba told him, there is someone, but he is lame at his feet. So, in other words, Ziba was saying he is not worthy to receive your help, king. Oh, non des sanamukan des etomolokwan des shiga gagada zendo kombre sovarandia. So we'll be praying from that and we'll say, Lord, nothing will disqualify us. Let's see how King David replied him. Verse 4. So the king said to him, where is he? So he did not even respond to him, telling him that, you know, this guy is lame. He just said, where is he? Oh, Melekon Zenia, nothing would disqualify you from the help of God. In the name of Jesus, turn that into a prayer and declare in the name of Jesus, I am not disqualified. Nothing disqualifies me. In the name of Jesus, everything that the devil will bring to serve as a disqualification in the name of Jesus, that will be the reason I'll be favored. In the name of Jesus, I am not disqualified. Pray in the name of Jesus, you are not disqualified. Nothing disqualifies you from the kindness that God wants to show you. In the name of Jesus, nasudu okopelia resuno mokoba and seto nomonoto reperus efarwatagaba. Nothing disqualifies you in the name of Jesus. Are you praying? Nothing disqualifies you. Nothing disqualifies you in the name of Jesus. Nothing at all. Resapalus equada reperus inamanoa eshakapalaba entenete ros antoboloto reperus esanamanos igomalatinon You are not disqualified, though, in the name of Jesus. Any tongue that will rise and to cause your disqualification is condemned right now, in the name of Jesus. Where your matter is discussed, in the name of Jesus, nothing will disqualify you. Where your matter is discussed, where your matter is discussed, nothing will disqualify you, in the name of Jesus. Ansilo kombarahante jekete gedon zekambri sobrahania. In the name of Jesus, we are praying. Something just dropped in my heart. Now, there are times that you are not even aware that your matter is being discussed in a certain place. And at those places, what you need is a voice that God will raise that will speak for you. If you don't have a voice in such places, let's say that you are being discussed, you know, there's a contract that should be given, and there are many applicants, there are many people, and then they sit down together and they are discussing. At that point, you need God to raise up a man, to raise up a voice that will stand for you. And I declare in the name of Jesus, as many as are in that place, you don't know about it, but I am praying for you. I declare that God raises a voice for you right now in the name of Jesus. It will be, that meeting will be to your favor in the name of Jesus. That meeting is to your favor because a voice will rise, a strong voice. God will raise a strong voice for you. He will raise a strong voice for you that will speak for you, that will defend for you. Nothing will disqualify you because of that voice. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Asikoto meneka deruze ikapaluga. Jekete nensumo morokoto. Ensumo monopolokoto siyaha. Verse 5. Then King David sent and brought him out of the house of Makai, the son of Amiel from Lodiba. Now, when Mephibosheth, the son of Jonathan, the son of Saul, had come to David, he fell to his on his face and prostrated himself. Then David said, Mephibosheth, and he answered, here is your servant. So David said to him, do not fear, for I will surely show you kindness for Jonathan, your father's sake, and will restore to you all the land of Saul, your grandfather, and you shall eat bread at my table continually. Ah, Jesus. Restoration. He said, I will restore to you. That means that when King Saul died, you know, there was war. What caused this guy to be lame was because there was kind of a war, and his nurse was trying to carry him and run, and he fell out of her hand and got lame from that situation. So his lameness was not his fault. It was not his fault that he was lame. So from that point, he did not, all the lands of his father Saul was taken away. And King David said, I will restore. I will restore. I hear in my spirit, I will restore. I will restore. I will restore. I will restore. The things you lost in 2015, God is saying, I will restore. The things you lost in 2017, I will restore. The things you lost in February, I will restore. In the name of Jesus, there is restoration. Zeka, uns engada, uzerua, zepronia. Lift up your voice right now and begin to cry, Lord, restore to me. In the name of Jesus, anything that I have lost. He said, the years that the canker worms have, even years, God is saying, I will restore years to you. In the name of Jesus, pray and say, Lord, bring restoration to me, to my family. Anything I have lost, anything that the enemy had made me to lose, in the name of Jesus, I speak restoration now. I declare you are restored. David told Mephibosheth, I will restore to you the lands, the lands of your father, King Saul. You will eat at my table. What a lifting that was. What a lifting that was. Apa Osie Kadana Osugo Aruas in Kaparu Esunwadrana Rosonto Kopo Ejiga Garus Equana Retetenonzia Menentos Iaka Nenezia de Sunua Gapalowa Resuno Molotom. The contracts are restored. Those contracts are restored in the name of Jesus. My soul Osudua Repenunzi. The years that you lost as a student, they are restored in the name of Jesus. Yes, Sanama. Jekin konzi esunwa resudo vekale ruzenenega menono monji gidigetela ruzavalatana. Those clients that you, it seemed as though you lost, God is bringing you multiple fold. He is bringing restoration in a bigger way. He said that the latter years of Job was better than his former years. In the name of Jesus, I declare your latter days are better than your former days. The clients that you lost, God restores in double fold in the name of Jesus. Oh, Zisia Tana Makwa Ze Dunzi Kapalu Risa Barwa Jeketeke de I Kapalu Rus Everwata Jeketeke Tenemonubolo Toka 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 Daha Rapapa Papa Laka Dieketeketea Resilo Tomono Monoka Daha. So, this was how the story of a man changed overnight. It does not take God anything to change your story. It does not take God anything to change your story. Don't buy into the lie of the devil that your end has come. Your story does not end till you say it has ended. Till you say it has ended, your story has not ended, no matter the depth you falling into. I declare in the name of Jesus, your story is not ended. Your story has not ended. Oh Jesus, Zofradi Kuneyanda Asieto Menasia. This man thought his story had ended. Even his mentality had begun to change. He had already started seeing himself as a dog. When you read down, he told Kikendebi, a dog like me is whom you are going to help. That means he had fallen to the lowest place, that he was equating himself to a dog. That was how sorry his circumstance had become. But overnight, God restored Paul and Sidokwa. I hear suddenly, in the name of Jesus, your story will be a suddenly kind of story. It will be like, suddenly God changed my story. Suddenly it happened as though it was overnight. Suddenly I was here. Suddenly I found myself there. Suddenly I was here. Suddenly I found myself there. Oh, that will be your testimony in the name of Jesus. The Lord grants you wisdom. He grants you wisdom. You need wisdom. The Lord is telling me there's someone you need wisdom to navigate the situation. In the name of Jesus, that wisdom comes to you. In the name of Jesus, that wisdom comes to you. That wisdom comes to you. In the name of Jesus, before the end of tomorrow, that's 2 days, that wisdom comes to you today and tomorrow. That wisdom comes to you 2 days. In the name of Jesus, that wisdom comes to you. In the name of Jesus. The Lord is saying you should spend time to worship, and then you become still and listen as you think over that situation. Clarity will come. You will receive instruction, direction, wisdom in the name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you for joining us. As usual, you can continue the prayer. You can keep praying. This is just to get you started. You understand? It's just to get you started. You can keep on praying till the Holy Ghost releases you. Thank you. God bless you. And this prayer is every Saturday by 10 p.m. GMT plus 1. Do well to invite your friends. Do well to share the video. The more you share the video, the more you like the video, the more you comment on the video, the more viral the video gets. Were you blessed? Let others get blessed. And the Lord will be exalted.
Thank you very much. God bless you. Do have a lovely night rest. I remind your brother Ogunaya Aboke, and see you in our next video. And if you've not subscribed, subscribe and click the notification bell. You'll be notified of all our videos. Thank you. God bless you. And bye. This is the final bye I'm telling you. Bye bye. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.